I am Professor S.M. Akram Hussain, Professor of Anatomy and Head of the Department, North Bengal Medical College, Sirajganj, Bangladesh. I am just demonstrating superior extremity from beginning from pectoral region up to the palm of the hand. I will identify and demonstrate the dissected parts of the different portions, pectoral region, axilla, front of the arm, front of the elbow, and front of the forearm and palm of the hand, identify the different structures so that student can easily identify those structures and correlate their understanding, theoretical understanding, with this practical identification for their subsequent learning process about the superior extremity. I think it will be very much beneficial for everybody, those who will engage with this or those who will go through this video clip. Thank you.
We are just demonstrating superior extremity and its different regions, beginning from pectoral region, then axilla, then arm, then elbow, front of the elbow, then front of the forearm, then palm of the hand. We will identify and demonstrate different structures so that students can identify those structures in their practical session, and they can easily identify those structures for their understanding process in subsequent learning activities of human anatomy regarding superior extremity. I am just beginning from pectoral region. Pectoral region, this one pectoral region, and it in the median plane, it extends up to this midline of this sternum, then along the clavicle superiorly, and inferiorly, this is the inferior border of the pectoris major muscle, Here incision, vertical incision has been given, and one oblique incision along the clavicle already given, so that we can deflect this skin, already deflected from here, superficial fascia and deep fascia already deflected from here, not seen at this moment. Only we are identifying pectoris major muscle, and this pectoris major muscle deflected from its attachment position in the median plane and superiorly, and deflected from here later. This is a pectoris major muscle. Underneath is pectoris major muscle, another small muscle, this is pectoris minor muscle. This one pectoris minor muscle. And these two muscles that will form the anterior wall of the axilla. You can easily identify these two muscles, it will form the anterior wall of the axilla, this armpit. And if you consider this lower border of the pectoris major muscle with pectoris minor muscle, and it will form the anterior axillary fold. And two muscles, it will form this anterior wall of the axilla, or you can say this is anterior position of the axilla. As axilla is the armpit, has so many valves. So pectoris major and pectoris minor we have already deflected, and here this is the nerve that will supply the pectoris major and pectoris minor muscle. There, this lateral and medial pectoral nerve, this is this one nerve, and this is another nerve. Lateral and medial pectoral nerve. This one and this one. If I hold these two nerve, then it is very easy. Lateral and medial pectoral nerve that will supply these two muscles. Very clear, these two muscles. And these two nerves come from lateral and medial cord of the brachial plexus. And these two muscles is supplied by lateral and medial pectoral nerve. Yeah? So now you can easily understand these two muscles. Now, this pectoralis minor muscle is very important and acts as landmark that will cover, this is the axillary artery, and underneath this, this is axillary artery begins, as axillary artery begins from outer part of the fascia. So it acts as landmark just to divide axillary artery first and second and third portions. So it is very important. Now, if I consider after the flexion of these two muscles, the portion, this is a very important area, this is the clavipectoral triangle. Clavipectoral triangle is covered with clavipectoral fascia. This is clavipectoral fascia. And it is pierced by, this is the cephalic vein. This is cephalic vein. That will pierce this. This is the clavipectoral fascia, and it will end in the axillary vein. This one axillary vein. And this fascia also pierces with this lateral pectoral nerve. And thoracoacromial artery, another artery. This is the another thoracoacromial artery over here. This is. So structures and lymphatics. So this is very important structures. Those passes, this is the clavipectoral fascia, and this is a triangle, clavipectoral triangle. So this is cephalic vein and pectoral nerve, lateral pectoral nerve, and thoracoacromial artery. Now, and this is the region below this clavicle, this is a subclavius muscle. Subclavius muscle, very important muscle, subclavius muscle. This one, subclavius muscle. Clear? So, this is about the anterior wall of the axilla that will form by the two muscles, pectoralis major and pectoralis minor. Now, I deflect this. Now, I am just exposing, this is the axilla, this one axilla or armpit axilla. It has anterior wall, this is posterior wall. And posterior wall is formed by, this is the latissimus dorsi muscle, latissimus dorsi, and teres major, latissimus dorsi, this one latissimus dorsi muscle. And that extends from below, from iliac crest, and come from iliac crest and go to this arm bone in the humerus. And with this, another muscle, this is come from scapula, this is the teres major muscle. Teres major muscle, very important. Teres major muscle. These two muscles actually form the posterior wall of the axilla. And these two muscles also form the posterior axillary fold. This is anterior axillary fold, and this one posterior axillary fold. Clear? So these two muscles, very important muscles on the back, skin scapular region, and back of the thorax. Latissimus dorsi is supplied by the one nerve. Thoracodorsal nerve, very important nerve, and thoracodorsal nerve comes from posterior part of the tracheal plexus. Very important nerve, thoracodorsal nerve, very important. Come from posterior part of the tracheal plexus. Yep. And this is the teres major muscle. Teres major muscle also supplied by this, another branch from the posterior cord. This is the very important. This is the long another nerve. We are not clear, but probably this one. This is the lower subscapular nerve. Lower subscapular nerve. That is supplied by the come from posterior part of the tracheal plexus. Clear? Now. Here one muscle, this is the serratus anterior muscle. Serratus anterior muscle. This muscle comes from anterior aspect of the thorax by 8 or 9 digitations from the ribs and go back under surface. This is the costal surface or medial surface of the scapula. Go to the costal surface of the medial border of the scapula. This is serratus anterior muscle. serratus. And this muscle is supplied by one nerve. This is the long thoracic nerve. Long thoracic nerve. This long thoracic nerve come from root of the brachial plexus. This is the long thoracic nerve. Root of the brachial plexus. 5, 6, and 7 ventral domain, cervical region. This is the long thoracic nerve. It will supply the serratus anterior muscle. Yeah. So I can summarize again. What are the walls of the axilla? Anterior, posterior. This is the medial. This is the lateral upper part, medial aspect of the arm. This is the floor. Skin superficial fascia, and you see this is the apex. This is apex. Very important apex. Apex of this, and this apex transmits the roots of the brachial. So these are brachial plexus, and this comes from apex underneath the clavicle. This is the apex. Yep. So now this is the axilla, and axilla contains so many groups of lymph nodes, as for example, lateral group or brachial group, medial group or thoracic, lateral thoracic group, posterior group or scapular group, subscapular group, anterior or pectoral group, and central and apical group. This is the central or apical group. Very important. The different groups of lymph node. Clear? So now you identify structures in axilla. Axilla contains vessels and nerves. Among nerves, different cords of the brachial plexus and their branches. Among the vessels, we can easily say this is the actually axillary artery, this one axillary artery. This is axillary artery. And this is the axillary vein. Axillary vein, this is axillary artery. Again, I hold, this is axillary artery. This is the third part of the artery. Axillary artery, it is the continuation of the subclavian artery from outer part of the fascia, and I have already told the axillary artery will divide it by, this is the pectoris minor muscle. Behind the pectoris minor muscle, this is the second part, from lower part of the pectoris minor up to the lower part of the teres major, this is the teres major muscle. This is the third part of the axillary artery. This is the third part of the axillary artery. And third part is related to different cords of the brachial plexus. As I have mentioned, these are the different cords of brachial plexus related to third part of the brachial axillary, third part of the axillary artery, this one. And this is axillary vein. Clear? Now, we can easily identify the cords of the brachial plexus as those are related with the third part of the axillary artery. Third part of the axillary artery is three branches. Second part, two branches. First part, only one branches. Now, cords related to third part of the brain. If I identify the cord, then I must firstly identify the musculocutaneous nerve. Here, musculocutaneous nerve emit atypical divisions or distribution. If you consider, this is musculocutaneous nerve with three branches. This is musculocutaneous nerve, this one musculocutaneous nerve, this one musculocutaneous nerve, and this one musculocutaneous branch, one branch. And this musculocutaneous nerve will supply muscles of the front of the forearm as bicep brachii muscle, this is the branch. This is brachialis muscle, this is another branch. This is another branch that will supply the coracobrachial muscle. This is coracobrachial muscle. Coracobrachialis. Again, this is coracobrachialis, very important. You can easily identify over here, this is coracobrachialis. It's one muscle, coracobrachialis. And this is another branch that will supply the bicep brachii muscle. Another branch that will supply the brachialis muscles. So these three muscles are the muscles of the front of the arm. And bicep brachii has two head. One is long head, this one long head. And this one short head. Short head. This one short head. And short head always come with in combination with this coracobrachialis. Coracobrachialis. Coracobrachialis and short head, this short head, both originate from tip of the coracoid process. Here tip of the coracoid process. Tip of the coracoid process. From the tip of the coracoid process. It will arise. But long head, if you consider this long head, very important. It is tendinous. You can see, is it understand the long head? It is tendinous. And it will come from supraglenoid tubercle of the scapula. Supraglenoid tubercle. And it is intracapsular but extrasynovial. And remains in front of the that's a humerus in the intertubercular sulcus. But short head is aponeurotic or flat tendon with coracobrachialis. And musculocutaneous nerve, as I have already identified the musculocutaneous nerve, this musculocutaneous arises from the lateral cord. This is the lateral cord. Musculocutaneous, three branches, a bit atypical divisions, usually come single, then it will give supply the different muscles of the front of the arm. Here, differently, it will supply from different. But as a whole, this is musculocutaneous nerve, this one. And it will give, it will arrest from this lateral cord. This is the lateral root of the median nerve. Lateral root of the median nerve. And this is the median root of the median nerve. So this is the median nerve. So this is lateral root, this is the median root, and this is the median nerve. The median root comes from medial cord. Here medial cord. Very important, medial cord. So this is the median root of the median nerve. And this is the lateral root of the median nerve. And this is the median nerve. And this is the musculocutaneous nerve. And this is the lateral cord. So this is medial cord. And if you hold these two, another cord present posteriorly, this is the posterior cord. Posterior cord. From which another nerve arises, this is the radial nerve. Very important. This is the radial nerve. This is the posterior cord. This is the posterior cord. And this is the radial nerve. This one radial nerve. Radial nerve go back. Posterior surface of the humerus in the radial group, that will supply muscles of the back of the arm. So cords are posterior cord, medial cord, and lateral cord. All these cords related to third part of axillary arteries. In relation to third part, this is medial part, this is the medial cord, lateral to this artery, lateral cord. Behind this artery is the posterior. This is the behind the posterior cord. And posterior cord is the largest branch is the radial nerve. Another nerve from posterior cord, very important over here. If I identify, this is very important, this one. This is the axillary nerve. This one, axillary nerve from the posterior cord. This is the posterior cord and this is the axillary nerve. Very important. So these two down, radial nerve and axial nerve from posterior cord. And I have already mentioned this is the thoracodorsal nerve from posterior cord. Lower subscapular nerve that supplies this is the teres major and upper subscapular nerve. So all are the branches of the posterior cord. And lateral cord, branch of musculocutaneous nerve, lateral root of the median nerve, and some cutaneous branches. And medial cord, if you consider medial cord, this medial cord, this ulnar nerve, This is ulnar nerve, main nerve, ulnar nerve. Ulnar nerve from medial cord, and this is the medial cutaneous nerve of the arm, medial cutaneous nerve of the arm, and also forearm that will come from medial cord. So, if I identify again, these are these cords and their branches. Now, artery is the, this is the axillary artery continuation, this is axillary artery, this is the brachial artery continued. Axillary continued from lower border of the teres major, this is the teres major muscle. From lower border, it will, this is the, from lower border, it will continue as brachial artery. And it will go in front of the elbow, the front of the forearm. And it will give one deep branch, largest branch in the arm, arteria profunda brachii, that will begin with the radial nerve, in the radial groove. Again, now muscles, again I am summarizing muscles, bicep brachii muscle is a short head. With short head, this is the coracobrachialis muscle. Common origin from tip of the coracoid process. Here, this is the coracobrachialis muscle. Coracobrachialis. This is the coracobrachialis, passed by muscular cutaneous nerve. This is short head, common origin. Then, this is the long head from supraglenoid tubercle. Collectively, it will form single belly, bicep brachii muscle, and another muscle, the brachialis muscle. Very clear, brachialis muscle, and that is supplied by these muscular cutaneous. And it will arise lower and anterolateral, anteromedial surface of the lower part of the front of the humerus. This is a brachialis muscle. White muscle from below. So these are the muscles of the front of the arm. And structures, again, you just clarify your understanding. This is the median nerve, muscular cutaneous nerve, this is the lateral cord, and medial root of the median nerve, lateral root of the median nerve, this is the median nerve, this is ulnar nerve from medial cord, this is medial cord, ulnar nerve. And this is radial nerve from posterior cord. Main three nerve, very, very important. Radial nerve, ulnar nerve, and median nerve. And this is the muscular cutaneous nerve. Artery, if you consider, this is the brachial artery, continue down, this is brachial artery. And brachial vein, this is the brachial vein, continue, this axillary vein, and brachial artery continued from axillary artery, from lower part of teres major muscle. Clear? So, now it is very clear about axilla and front of the arm. If we consider now, this is the muscle, bicep brachii muscle. I have already mentioned two head. It will unite and it will form single belly, and at the end it will very narrow rope-like structure. This is the tendon of the bicep brachii, tendon, bicipital tendon. This is the tendon of the bicep brachii, very clear. This tendon of the bicep brachii, this one, tendon of the bicep brachii. And now, you go another one, and the bicipital aponeurosis, this one bicipital aponeurosis, if you can see this. This is tendon, and this is bicipital aponeurosis, very clear. And the bicipital aponeurosis is a flat tendon, and it will attach to anti-brachial fascia. precipitous apophysis. And tendon is a rope-like structure. This rope-like structure. And this tendon, if you consider this tendon, it will attach to this radial tuberosity. Radial tuberosity. Now, if you consider these structures, this is the median nerve and this is the brachial artery. Intimate relation over here. And this is vein also, brachial vein. Intimate relation over here. This is artery and vein. This is the nerve, median nerve. Those inters in the front of the curam underneath the bicipital epiphysis. And bicipital epiphysis actually gives support to these structures. And over the bicipital epiphysis, one vein remains, median cubital vein. That will connect the cephalic vein, this one cephalic vein. Cephalic vein, this one cephalic vein. Very important, cephalic vein. And here one vein present, usually present over here inside, basilic vein, and this is the median cubital vein connect. This median cubital vein is very important for intravenous infusion and catheterization. And during catheterization or intravenous injection, and this introduction of this needle or catheter, it will give support. This bicipital epiphysis gives support and protect this two structures, this median nerve and brachial artery. As those go in underneath this bicipital epiphysis and enters within the pleura. And median nerve, and this is the artery. And artery remains just medial to the tendon. If you consider this tendon, yeah, just medial to the tendon, first this is the artery. Then nerve. Here, it's very important clinically. Here we do feel pulse of the brachial artery. And this tendon will give guideline. Tendon give guideline in semiplaced elbow. In the bed tense and cord-like structure, just medial this the pulsation of the brachial artery before auscultation of the blood pressure. We place bail of the stethoscope over here. Clear? So it is very important clinically. Now it is very clear about this is entry of this artery and nerve and muscles, this one muscles of the front. One muscles I have already described the acroaxial, one muscles over here, this is prominency of the shoulder, is formed by this deltoid muscle. This is the deltoid muscle. And deltoid muscle has this enteric fiber, this is the clavicular fiber, this is the clavicle. Clavicular fiber is enteric fiber. Medial fiber, acromial fiber, this one acromial fiber, is the multifidant origin, and posterior bird from the spine of the scapula. So it will form the prominency of the shoulder, deltoid muscle, and it is supplied by axillary nerve. I have already identified. Yeah? So this is about the front of the arm, axilla, about shoulder, and just before entry. Now, if consider this one, triangular area, this is the cubital fossa, triangular. And base is formed by medial and lateral epicondyle. This is the medial and lateral epicondyle. This is the medial epicondyle and lateral. Behind the medial epicondyle, ulnar nerve enters. So the two heads of the flexor carpi ulnaris. Flexor carpi ulnaris muscle. This is the median nerve. Enters to the true head of the flexor carpi ulnaris muscle. This is ulnar nerve behind the medial epicondyle. But median nerve enters between the two heads of the pronotitis. This is the pronotitis muscle. The humeral head, ulnar head, pronotitis muscle that will gives entry for this median nerve. This is the median nerve. Entry for the median nerve. This is median nerve. Very important. medial nerve. It is empty for the medial nerve between the two head of the promotor teeth. This is the promotor teeth muscle. Clear? Promotor teeth. And this is also entry point for tracheal artery. Now, if you give boundary of this cubital fossa, this base, and promotor teeth, this is the medial boundary, this is the promotor teeth, lateral border of the promotor teeth, and lateral boundary, this is the medial border of the brachioradialis. This is the union side, this is the apex. So, base, apex, medial border, and lateral border. This is the cubital fossa. Contains tendon of the bicep brachii. I have already shown tendon of the bicep brachii, tendon, and this is median nerve and brachial artery. Brachial artery, I have brachial artery. This is the main contents. And brachial artery always medial to this bicep brachii tendon. Cubital fossa. And floor of this cubital fossa, if you consider floor is contains, this is the muscle, brachialis muscle. And through the floor, it will go down and it will insert it to the, in front of the coronoid process of ulnar, in the ulnar tuberosity. Clear? And this muscle, I have already told, supply with the musculocutaneous cutaneous nerve. Here, very important, here another nerve in the just medial to the, lateral to this cubital fossa, which is very important nerve. This is the radial nerve. This radial nerve also supplies this part of this brachialis muscle, small lateral part. Most medial part is supplied by this nerve, musculocutaneous. So, dual nerve supply, this bicep, brachialis muscles supply, dual nerve supply. This musculocutaneous nerve, after giving supply to muscle, it becomes cutaneous, lateral to the elbow, as medial cutaneous nerve, this lateral cutaneous nerve of the cura. Clear? Now, you go down, this is the front of the forearm, beginning from elbow, in front of the wrist. This portion is the front of the forearm. This front of the forearm contains 8 muscles. Superficial 5, deep 3. 8 muscles. And nerves, usually 3 nerves, main 2 nerves, in addition another nerve, and 2 arteries. If I identify first of all muscle lateral to medial superficial group, this is the promotor teres, then flexor carpi radialis, again promotor teres, flexor carpi radialis, palmaris longus, flexor digitorum superficialis, superficial tendons, flexor digitorum superficialis, and flexor carpi ulnaris. Again, promotor teres, flexor carpi radialis, palmaris longus, flexor digitorum superficialis, and flexor carpi ulnaris. The superficial 5 muscles. Deep 3 muscles among those are deep 3 muscles. This is the flexor pollicis longus, then flexor digitorum profundus, very important muscle. Flexor digitorum profundus, yes. Flexor digitorum profundus muscle, 4 tendons. And this is the promotor quadratus. This one, promotor quadratus. Promotor quadratus, this one. quadrat, pronator quadratus. Again, repeat. This is a flexor pollicis longus. Flexor digitorum profundus, deep muscle, core tendon. And pronator quadratus. This is pronator quadratus, very important. So, 8 muscle complete. Now, nerve. I have already mentioned one important nerve over here. This is the, I have already mentioned from here, this is the median nerve. Median nerve, this one nerve. Median nerve. Median nerve. Then ulnar nerve. So median nerve, median nerve, I have already again, hold it. This median nerve and ulnar nerve. Clear? Ulnar nerve and median nerve. And the cutaneous nerve, this is the cutaneous branch of radial nerve. Cutaneous branch of the radial nerve. So three nerves. Arteries, this is the radial artery. This is the branch, this is brachial artery. Brachial artery in, just medial to this, neck of the radius, divide into radial artery and another artery here. This is another artery. Here, identify. Over here. Yes, this is the another artery. So, radial artery and another artery. Radial and ulnar come from terminal branch of this brachial artery, from just medial to the neck of the radius. And these two artery you can easily identify in the front of the forearm. Especially the radial artery is very important. It will identify in lower part of the front of the forearm, just mid lateral to the flexor carpi radialis tendon. You see, flexor carpi radialis tendon, and just lateral to this, this is the radial artery. This is the lower part of the radius, in front of the lower part of the radius. Here we do field pulse, radial pulse. Radial pulse, very important. Just lateral to this flexor carpi radialis tendon. Clear? And this is the radial artery. And one important thing here, this is the vein, cephalic vein, the superficial vein. It will go like this and it will end. This is the cephalic vein, deltopectoral group, and it will end in the axillary vein. I have already told after passing the clavicular fascia. And inside another vein, brachial vein, and it will pass mid arm, deep to the superficial fascia, deep fascia, then continue as axillary artery. The brachial artery, then axillary artery. This is the brachial artery, then axillary artery. So, this cephalic vein ends in the axillary vein directly after passing the clavicular fascia, beginning from here, lateral aspect of the dorsum of the hand. And basilic vein, deep in the mid arm, continue to the brachial vein, then axillary vein from lower part of the pterygoid major, and continue to the subclavian vein. So, we are demonstrating here. So muscles complete, three nerve complete, two artery complete. This is the front of the forearm. Now, this is the region in front of the wrist. Here deep fascia is thickened over here like this. It will form the flexor retinaculum. Flexor retinaculum. Just to hold up the tendons, flexor tendons, for their entry within the palm of the hand. If you cut, remove, this is by transverse section, transverse incision, lateral medial, then we can easily identify those structures go to the palm of the hand underneath this flexor retinaculum. Here, we identify, firstly, most superficially, This is the palmar. This is palmar is longest muscle. And it will end in this palmar epiphysis. This is the apex, this is the deep part of the palm, palmar epiphysis. Here, it will end the apex of the palmar epiphysis. It gives sites for the attachment of the palmaris longus. This is the palmaris longus. This is the palmar epiphysis. And deep to this, you see, deep to this, this is the flexor digitorum superficial tendon. And deep to this, this is the median nerve. This is median nerve. And flexor digitorum superficial tendon, just below this tendon, the flexor digitorum profundus tendon. All tendons go in underneath this flexor retinaculum to the palm of the hand. So flexor digitorum superficialis and flexor digitorum profundus. And median nerve, this median nerve. This is median nerve. And ulnar nerve also, ulnar nerve here, you see, ulnar nerve, if you identify this one ulnar nerve. This ulnar nerve, this is median nerve. Yes, median nerve. This is radial artery and this is ulnar artery. Ulnar artery. Structures. This is median nerve, this is ulnar nerve, and this is radial artery, this is the ulnar artery. Median nerve underneath the flexor radium go in. Ulnar nerve, one superficial branch gives over this flexor retinaculum, it will have superficial branch, deep branch underneath this flexor retinaculum. Radial artery, it will enter in the palm of the hand through the anatomical snag box, not underneath the flexor retinaculum. But ulnar artery go over the flexor retinaculum and it will go to the palm of the hand. Then radial and ulnar artery, after coming with the palm of the hand, they will cooperate each other by so many branches and direct continuation from deep palmaris proximally, then superficial palmaris distally. By entry, ulnar artery go in superficial to this flexor retinaculum, radial artery go in through the anatomical snap box and through the two head of these first dorsal interosseous muscle. In the palm of the hand, if you consider now, groups, different compartments, this is the thinner, this is the hypothinner, and this is the medial compartment. A medial compartment, thinner compartment control muscle, hypothinner compartment, this is eminence control four muscles, and this intermediate central compartment contains lumbricus muscle, dorsal interosseous and palmar interosseous muscle, and all flexor tendons, superficial and deep tendon. If you try to locate these two tendons, superficial and deep tendon, the superficial tendon is split just in front of the metacarpophalangeal joint. This is the metacarpophalangeal joint. It will split and it will split here and accommodates the deep tendon. Accommodates the deep tendon. This is yes. This is accommodation. This is the divisions of the superficial tendon, and it through these superficial divisions, this it will enter this deep tendon. Here, see, this is the deep tendon. This is deep one, and the superficial one. This two slips, and it will attach to this east side of the base of the medial phalanx. And deep one continue over the medial phalanx. And it will attach the palmar aspect of the base of the distal phalanx. This is the mode of insertion of this superficial and deep tendon. That is flexor digitorum superficialis and flexor digitorum profundus. Another thing in the central region, if you write on this deep tendon, always in combination with the lumbricus muscle. This is the lumbricus muscle. This is one. This is another. Lumbricus. This is third one. This is fourth one. So four lumbricus muscles. And other than this, this inter metacarpal space contains palmar interossei. Palmar interossei, here palmar interossei, and dorsally dorsal interossei. Dorsal interossei are these. This is the dorsal, palmar is the palmar, right? And the X over this. This muscle, short muscle, acts over this metacarpophalangeal joint, interphalangeal joint, through the dorsal digital expansion. Clear? Now, thinner remains, if you consider these muscles, four muscles, this is a flexor pollicis brevis. Abductor pollicis, opponens pollicis, and adductor pollicis. Here also, foot muscle, flexor digiti minimi, abductor digiti minimi, opponent digiti minimi, then another superficial muscle with the superficial fascia, palmaris brevis. All these small muscles, different segments, this is the thinner, hypothinner, intermediate segments. Most of the muscles are supplied by deep terminal branch of the ulnar nerve. This ulnar nerve, I have already shown ulnar nerve, this one ulnar nerve. This deep terminal branch of the ulnar nerve is to supply most of the muscles. Some muscles supplied by this median nerve. But cutaneous supply, you see, this three and half, one, two, three, and the real side of the half, it is cutaneous supply, dermatome by the median nerve, and rest one and a half by the ulnar nerve, except in this ABT. This is variations of the tip of the fingers, dorsal and palmar aspects.
So, I have already demonstrated different portions of this perceptive part of this superiority front, begin from pectoral region up to the palm of the hand. I think this demonstration and identification of the different structures of the different regions will be very much beneficial for this first year and second year student, not only that, all medical students, and they will apply this practical knowledge for their practical application of the medical science. I hope this will be their permanent knowledge developing process. Thank you.